I would like to welcome the viewers of this PPT session. This is Sathish Kumar, Associate Professor, SEDU Institute of Technology. Now, we are going to see the object-oriented programming concept, inheritance. The definition of object-oriented programming, I think all of you well known about object-oriented programming definition. Object-oriented programming refers to the type of programming in which programmers are defining both data members and member functions called encapsulation. The encapsulated data is being defined using data type and member function. The four pillars of object-oriented programming are: one is encapsulation, next one is abstraction, third one is inheritance, and fourth one is polymorphism. Encapsulation is nothing but the data is encapsulated both the data member and member functions within the class. That is called encapsulation. And abstraction is nothing but we are hiding some irrelevant details and we are showing the relevant details, called abstraction. And next one is inheritance. That is what today's discussion. Inheritance is the process of creating new classes from the existing or base class. The inherited class will have both the properties of base class and inherited class. Next one is polymorphism. Polymorphism is nothing but the ability to have more than one form. The function, more than one function with the same name but with the different parameters. We call that as a polymorphism. Inheritance is the process of creating new classes from the existing or base class. The inherited class inherits both the properties of base class and the inherited class. Types of inheritance: one is a single inheritance, and next one is multiple inheritance, and next one is multi-level inheritance, and next one is hierarchical inheritance, and last one is hybrid inheritance. We have five different inheritance are available. We are going to discuss each and everything in detail. First one is single inheritance. Here we have two classes. One is base class and another one is derived class. The derived class, after the derivation, the derived class is having the properties of both base class and derived class. This is the outline or the skeleton of single inheritance. Here we have two classes. The first one is base class and next one is derived class. The derived class B will have both the members of base class and the derived class when we are creating the object of the particular class B. After creating the object using the class B, the object of B will have both the properties of A and B. And the example for single inheritance, here we have a base class with one data member and one member function to get the data. And the next one is we have a derived class. In that we have one data member and two member functions. One is to read the data of a particular derived class data member, and next one is product of the first member which is available in the base class and the second member is available in the derived class. When we are creating the object for the derived class in the main function, here we have the object name is small a, will have both the members of base class and derived class. So we are getting the data using a data. Automatically the x will be assigned whatever we are giving the help of a single base class. And after that, a dot read data, here we are getting the details of detail of y. And after that, product will be called. Product, the member, product is a member of the derived class derived. So after getting these two data, a data and read data, with the help of product member function, we are getting the product of x and y. That's all. This is an simple example for single inheritance. Next one is multiple inheritance. Here, in the previous case, we had one base class and one derived class. But in this case, we have two base classes and one derived class. So more than one base class for a derived class. We call that particular concept is called multiple inheritance. The skeleton or the syntax, simple syntax for multiple inheritances. Here we have three different classes. The first two classes are base classes. The next one is, third one is the derived class. The derived class C will have both the members of A and B when they are creating the object of particular class called C. The example for multiple inheritance, here we have the base class A and base class another base class B. Within that we have some members, both data member and member functions. After that we have the class C, in which we are publicly inheriting the classes A and B. After creating the object for the class C, it will have all the members of A, B, C. This is called multiple inheritance. Next one is multi-level inheritance. Here we have the derived class with the help of another derived class. We are deriving some class with the help of another derived class. Like that, we have one base class and two derived classes. The derived class 2 is derived from the derived class 1. After creating the object for derived class 2, the members are base class members, derived class members, and derived class 2 members. All will be available at a stretch. This is the syntax for multi-level inheritance. Here I have a class A called base class and class B called derived class, which inherits the base class A, and after that class C is inheriting the class B. So whenever we are creating the object of class C, the members are class A members, class B members, and also class C members will be available in the particular object which is created using the class C. Next one is multi-level inheritance. The example for multi-level inheritance, here I have a single base class and two derived classes. The first derived class is constructed using the base class, and second derived class is constructed or defined using the derived class 1. So after creating the object of derived class 2, the members of base class and derived class 1 and 2 will be available. And the fourth one is hierarchical class. Here I have one base class but more than one derived classes. That is, for more than one derived class, single base class. If it is the case, then we call this as a hierarchical inheritance. The syntax for hierarchical inheritance is, the base class called A and class B is available. The derived class is A and class C is defined. The derived class is A and class C is defined with the help of a base class A. Base class A is derived. So example for this one is, here I have a class A, a base class, and all the other two members are derived classes of B and C respectively. So after creating the class C, the members will be available, the A members and C members. The last one is hybrid inheritance. Here I have a class A and class B, class C and D. For class B, the derived class is class B is derived with the help of base class A, and also C is derived with the base class A. After that, the class D is derived from both B and C. The outline or the skeleton of this particular inheritance is, class A is available, class B with the help of A as base class for the derived class B, and for the derived class C, A is a base class which is going to use by the class C, and also D is the derived class of base classes B and C. The example for this one is, base class A is available and derived class B, correspondingly we have D also. B and B, C, D are derived classes, But in the case of D, is derived from B and C. So after creating the class, after creating the object for this particular class D, the class D object will be both the members of class D, class B and class C. So the merits of inheritance is reusability and readability. This is the major advantage, that is why we go for inheritance. When child class inherits the properties and the functionality of parent class, no need to write the same code again in the child class. This is the major advantage, that is why we go for inheritance. It is also giving much more readable than the other programming concepts. So we can go for inheritance whenever we need to have the same coding again and again. Thank you.